Okay. Time to freak you in. Let Ricky know.
Deacon, gotta go.
It's done. They won't be shooting up any more camps.
Thank God. I'll let Iron Mike know. You know, keep this up and you and Mike are gonna be best friends before you know it. Right.
Down those boys, shot up the gate, and took off.
Hey, Mike, yeah. I found them, and they won't be coming back.
Seems like it's getting worse. The amount of squatters and drifters we got coming through. No offense to present company.
Yeah, Mike, it's getting worse. I don't know. Mike, I think it's like you were saying about tourists always coming up here from California.
Well, I guess if I had the choice,
yeah,
I'd rather be here than down there.
So, see you, Deke. Iron Mike out.
Deacon, you there?
Yeah, Addie, what's up?
Can you stop by the infirmary when you get a chance?
Anything wrong?
No, I just need to talk to you.
Yeah, okay.
Deacon, when you get time, swing by the camp, a job's come up.
Ricky, yeah, okay, I'll be by. St. John out.
Come on. Hey, how many drifters you guys murder today, huh? Yeah, I can...
Thank you.
doing. I smell a nest. Gotta be right here. Another one. Yeah, time to light it up. I smell it. It's gotta be getting close. Another nest. Let's go. is it. Should be it.
Hey, Deacon, you got a second? How's William? I haven't seen him lately.
How's Boozer? How the hell are any of us? He's surviving.
Yeah, well, then he's doing better than most.
Yeah.
Listen, you need to keep an eye on him.
What do you mean?
Well, losing an arm is a big adjustment. He's given up the life he had.
Wasn't much of a life, Addie.
You're his friend. The only one he's got.
Boozer's fine. He'll live anyway.
So, a couple months ago, we were up by
Let me get the gate.
Yes.
Open up, don't get all day.
Hold on, I know. Open up. Hey, Boozman. How's it work?
What's it look like?
Okay. See you.
Hey, Addy, you there?
Deacon, yes, I'm here.
Hey, so, I don't think that he's doing so well. I don't know, I guess.
Stop by, he seemed. Hey, impressed.
Look, I'll keep an eye on him. I'm gonna make sure he doesn't do anything stupid. See what I can do. I don't know.
You do that, Deacon. A lot to me. Infirmary out.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. About a month before shit went down, I wrote in my newsletter, Farewell Freedom, store a year's worth of food and water. Because I knew, no matter what was coming, we were on 9 meals from anarchy.
Get the bastard! He killed him!
If I could get a few people prepared, the ones who'd really listen, then maybe we'd survive when it all finally collapsed down on our heads. Not as many listen as I'd hoped. Now, those supplies are running out, and folks are going hungry. Remember the parable of the ant and the grasshopper? Well, us ants, who prepared and stored for future calamity, didn't have the heart to starve out you grasshoppers. We danced while the sun was shining, without a worry in your head for what calamities the future would bring. Now, we're all paying the price. Are we gonna starve? I don't know. Fish runs are thinning out. Game is getting scarce. Can't remember the last time I saw a buck or a doe.
It doesn't look too bad.
But I'll tell you this much. We're not turning on each other.
No, sir.
We'll never do that. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Damn truth or bullshit. You know, last I checked, the grasshoppers all armed themselves to the teeth, came in, and killed all your fucking...
Here we go. You like that asshole? I guess you won't be ambushing anyone else today. Renegade Patrol. God damn it.
Pull back.
Oh, crap.
Back.
I gotta reload. Last of them. Won't be needing this.
Hey,
was here. I thought I saw someone out there. I thought I had him. He's gone.
Open the gate. The first one.
I live in this little town called Sisters outside of Fairwell. So, I'm sick as hell. Beaver. I tried calling my wife at work.